today's video, I'm going to be talking about how the market has rebounded as a result of the World Cup Hero SBC coming out. So, just before the video does start, a quick little ad on a trading service I offer over on Twitch. For the cheapest premium trading service for just £4, €4, or free with Amazon Prime, you'll get yourself daily trading and investing guides covering both Xbox and PlayStation with an array of different techniques depending on your budget. I've been trading for over 10 years, making over 100 million on multiple titles, and recently making over 10 million in the first month for the last 3 years. So in today's video, what we're going to be doing is just talking about how the market's rebounded as a result of the World Cup Hero Pack SBC coming out, and then we're going to talk about how I think the rest of the market will react, how long I think the rebound's going to have, and if there's any last sort of buys you can buy which, you know, I can spot stuff being cheap. So the SBC came out, and it was cheaper than what we expected it to be. I mean, it's going to come out at the best part of 113k, which is literally cheaper than the most recent 86 plus Hero or World Cup Hero SBC. The requirements are quite interesting. Only a one team. Again, it was a lot cheaper than what we expected. 387s left 87s to go from about 21k all the way up to 30, but I believe they've crashed back down again, which really is starting to show that fodder is only becoming more and more overinvested. They're actually starting to rebound now. 88's down a lot. A lot of these cards are getting down as of the SBC coming out. Why? Because fodder was way more invested than, you know, than fodder is needed. Obviously, everyone is doing this SBC, but because it's only one part, that's only 11 players being used. On top of that, it's going to be an 86 rated team. That limits the rating that's needed. You're not going to be using 91s in it. And yeah, it's a very cheap team. Now, it's also only repeatable once. That's another big thing. It's only repeatable once and it expires in 3 days' time, which means that we could go and get this repeatable again on, or get this released again on Thursday. It's kind of a bit up in the air. We've seen EA have SBCs that expire and then they release the exact same SBC again. We've also seen EA just pre-schedule the SBC being repeatable, aka when you know that it will be repeatable in 3 days. So we're not quite sure if it's going to be repeatable again, which will affect how the market rebounds. Obviously, because the market dropped before this SBC, if they go and drop another one of these SBCs, it will go and drop the market like it did today. But if they don't drop it, it will continue to rise. On the topic of stuff continuing to rise, the market will continue to rise for, in my opinion, at least Thursday, Friday, presuming that, again, this SBC isn't, you know, re-released. Now, the sort of trend I expect to see is the trend of that happened from the 28th, 3 to 1 or 2 weeks. Now, what happened with this promo is it was followed by this promo, and this promo was rubbish, and this promo was also kind of rubbish, but, you know, because the other promo was so rubbish, these cards kept rebounding. Now, that is going to be one of the major factors of if the market is going to stop rebounding this Friday or next Friday. So, if next Friday, the promo that we are getting is, if I can go and load it up for you guys right now, FIFA 23 EA Sports. Basically, EA on their official site show us all the World Cup promos we're going to get. So we scroll down here and there we go. We see on December the 6th, we are going to go and get ourselves a promo, which is dubbed as, because this card has a card name of Foot Stars. Now, interesting enough, this promo is also the promo which you can redeem your token players for. So you see that card design? It is the exact same card design as the one right here, if I'm not wrong. It's just, you see how this looks purple? It's just because of the fade on the card. You can see that it's light blue, red. And then if we look at this, light blue, red, with a blue bottom of the card. Again, that would be a blue bottom of the card. It's just very faded. But yeah, so this is a Foot Stars item, I believe. The promo is again dubbed as Foot Stars. Now, I believe Foot Stars is just going to be Team of the Tournament. Obviously, they show that as the last promo. You know, they normally do performance-based promos. Bear in mind, we've not seen any Man of the Match cards, which has been slightly weird. We kind of knew there wouldn't be Man of the Match cards because it wasn't in the database. But it's still a bit weird that we, you know, haven't had any Man of the Match or even, you know, any sort of special cards for this tournament that are, you know, performance-based or performance-awarded, let's say. So, if this promo comes out, and again, it is nothing more than just, here you go, you play pretty well, here's a double inform upgrade, you'll probably see the market continue to rebound. Because if a promo isn't very interesting, then I can't see, you know, I can't see players really going up. Now, obviously, if they go and just hyper, you know, give people insane upgrades, then I can see it dropping the market because people go, oh, I want to try this new card because this new card's interesting. But the worry is it's just going to be another one of these promos where it's just, here you go, here's a doubling form upgrade. So until stuff gets leaked, we don't quite know if the market is going to continue rebounding for 2 weeks because one promo sucks, the market keeps rebounding, or if it's only going to rebound till this Thursday. Another worry is that if they do go and do performance-based cards, is if they'll do what they did with Danny Alves. Now, obviously, they only did what they did with Danny Alves because he doesn't have a club. But the worry is, again, that they have an outside chance of going, okay, because, you know, this was a performance-based special card for the nation, you're going to get one of these nation links rather than getting the club link. Again, it's only really happened for transfer players, so this isn't guaranteed to happen. It's just, you know, an outside thing that would make the cards even less demanded. There are a pretty decent team of the tournament predicted. If I do go and give you guys the predicted tournament, again, you can normally find this under who scored. If you head underway with international competitions, we scroll down to the bottom all season, we can see the team that we would go and get. It'd be a Griezmann, Messi up front with a Kylian Mbappe right wing, Carlos Casemiro, Bellingham centre mid, Bruno Fernandes out on the left, Hakimi left back, Alaba right back, Jordi Alba and Maguire centre backs, with Szczesny goalkeeper. But the problem with this team is, again, if they're just going to give them double inform upgrades no different to this promo here, then I can't really see it dropping the market. Because, in all fairness, a lot of these players have actually had promo cards. Bruno Fernandes already had one of these promo cards. Kylian Mbappe already had one of these promo cards, which, again, is just nothing more than just a second in form. There's the first in form, there's the second in form. Say the Bruno Fernandes, hopefully I'll be able to show you that that was, once again, nothing more than just a second in form. If we head here, Bruno Fernandes, 86. Next in form, I think, would be an 88. All right, you got a triple in form. But still, this promo wasn't good enough to drop the market, and here's where I can prove. So, the last time we had the World Cup Hero SBC, this is what they dropped down to. They dropped down to the Monday, just like how they dropped down to the Monday this week, and then they started rebounding, which we can see with the current promo cards and special cards. So, they kept on rebounding until Friday. Now, if the promo was really good, this would drop the market, just like how a few of last week's promo players dropped when Friday hit. So, that was last week's promo. Let's go and find some of these guys who dropped on Friday. Go on, fit my agenda. Perfect to fit the agenda. Richarlison went from 575k, new promo came out. This promo was, for some reason, well, this Phenomenon's promo was so good, it went and dropped him 75k. We can already see, by the way, that he started rebounding. 485, already starting a rebound of 500. We look at his hourly graph. When the SBC came out, he was 492. Not massive rebound since, but 500. But yeah, they can should continue rebounding. I mean, the thing with this card maybe isn't showing too much demand as a result of him dropping. So when the promo's good, aka this promo came out, this drops some of the old promo cards. But when the promo is bad, aka this promo here, the old cards can rebound. And on top of that, because this promo was actually good enough to drop those cards, we know that this promo is quite well demanded. So some of the rebounds, or some of the cards that I recommended to buy from these, they're already looking up quite nicely. You've got Saka, was quite easy to go and buy at 100. He's already up to 108, so that's an 8% increase. We've got Pedri, who I recommended to go and buy at 245. Again, these recommended is all live on stream, all free, all streams on Twitch. 245, he's already up to 260. Obviously, that's going to be like a 6, 7% increase. Guendouzi, who I recommended to buy at 107. Once again, these are all easily buyable prices. I don't do this whole recommend 20k cheaper than they're going for, and then, you know, the flex looks nicer. 107 again was buyable. He's already up 11k, so that's nearly a 10% increase in a matter of hours. And again, these cards should at least rebound till Thursday, and then depending on the promo, it will depend how they do. Some of the other cards that I thought would do quite well is some of the Path to Glories that have been really panic sold since since their game they lost. Again, not looking too bad. 185 already rebounded 12k. Another one was Jack Grealish. He had a bit of a weird trend because he didn't really drop too much today, but no. Jack Grealish recommended at the likes of 67. He's already rebounded 71. It's not too amazing. Another one, Zakaria, 200k. Once again, very easy to achieve. He's only rebounded 206. You can see some of these cards, you know, still have an investing opportunity. But I'd say that's about all she wrote. Just a little update of what's happened with the market after the World Cup pack. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys tomorrow with a brand new video.